Welcome to the Stop Over Drinking and Start Living podcast, where high-achieving, goal-oriented rebel women come to learn how to live a vibrant and fulfilling life without requiring alcohol to get through it. No labels, no judgments, no saying you'll never drink again, just real proven methods to help you stop rebelling against yourself with alcohol so you can drink less and do more. I'm your host, Angela Mascenik. Let's dig in. Welcome to episode 146, What You Know How to Do. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back, everybody. So happy to be here this week. Lots of exciting things happening. We are putting the final touches on our new Stop Over Drinking and Start Living coaching program. I'm so excited to let you know that it's almost ready. And you all can come on and sign up for it if you've been waiting for me to publicly open that. So I'm actually going to be having two live Q&A session calls that'll be held over Zoom on October 15th at 10 a.m. and October 20th. And all of the links to join one of those or both Q&A style calls is in the show notes. So just click through and find that information. But basically on these calls, I'm going to be sharing the details of the new coaching program, giving you a little preview, breaking down what we're doing inside the program and the new content and all of that, and then how you can join. So you make sure if you're interested in that to come and save your spot for one of those Q&A calls. And this is where you can ask me questions to understand if you might be a good fit for the program and to get my direct feedback on your questions, your specific goals and needs to stop over drinking and to accomplish those goals. We'll do all of that together on these live Q&A calls. I'm really, really excited. So it's official. You can click through. Also, if you're ready to go and you know that you want to join the program, if you know that already, you can click through and actually apply to join me. So the link to do that is in the show notes here as well. And we are going to be doing a live kickoff, everybody together, on October 26th. So we're enrolling now, and then we're going to do a live workshop together to help you get your goals together, help your mindset in the right place, and do some coaching so that you start the program in the best possible place you can and get all of your questions answered so that you can be the most successful from the get-go. I'm really, really excited about it. All right, so today I want to talk to you all about knowing things that you already know how to do. So often I hear from people about stopping over drinking and they're like, I don't know how to go to a social engagement and not drink, or I don't know how not to drink on the weekends or on vacation, or, you know, and they just sort of worry about that. And this idea came to me when I was actually running this morning. So one of my clients, you shall remain nameless, you probably know who you are, emailed me about running. And she's actually training for a half marathon, and so am I. And she said, oh, the last 2 miles were not easy. This was in response to an email that I had sent out about, you got to be willing for it to be hard, for it to become easy. And she's like, I have to say that these last 2 miles on this 11-mile run was not easy. And so I read that email before I went on my 11-mile run today. And, you know, I'm like, how can I not have extra hardness on my last 2 miles? How can I enjoy these last 2 miles? Because, you know, it is hard to run 11 miles. And I mean, it may not be for somebody that runs 20 miles all the time, right? But for somebody who is training for something, and in this process, like, you're training to do something that you probably haven't done before, or it's been a while, right? And so we're conditioning our bodies to be able to go for longer periods of time. And so we don't get injured, right? So I haven't run 11 miles in a long time. And, you know, I wouldn't say it's not hard. So anyway, let me finish what I was trying to do. So I wanted to make the end of this run, which normally feels hard and painful, not so hard and painful. I wanted to kind of like prove her wrong that it wasn't going to be hard and that it could be easy. So what I was doing was I was running and I was approaching these last 2 miles, and I'm like, you know, I know how to run. This is what I was thinking in my head. I know how to run, so I don't have to learn how to run right now. I already know how to do that, so that's easy. I know how to breathe. That's easy. I know how to navigate the map or where I'm going, so I know exactly where I'm going. That felt easy. I can see things, I can smell things, I can hear things while I'm running. All of that felt easy. My lungs and my breathing felt easy. Like I wasn't exasperated or gasping for air or anything like that. So I filled my brain with what I knew how to do. I knew how to breathe, I knew how to run, I knew how to navigate. And I just sort of repeated that to myself over and over in my head. And lo and behold, it didn't feel hard because of that, because I managed my mind while I was running. Now I did notice that I had some pain in my feet and my hips and my knees. And before I even, so like in this process, I was like kind of scanning my body to see how I felt. And my brain kind of wanted to be like, your feet hurt and your knees hurt. And so I sort of stopped it in that moment. I'm like, I'm having sensations in my feet. I'm having sensations in my knees. I'm having sensations in my hips. And then I continued like looking at the rest of my body and noticing like what my arms felt like and what my face felt like and my chest and my thighs and my calves. And I'm like, oh, everything else feels really good. I'm just having some sensations in my feet, in my knees, in my hips. I know how to run. I know how to breathe. Running is easy, right? So I just sort of like repeated those types of things over and over in my head. And when I finished the run, I'm like, yeah, like that wasn't, I wouldn't describe it as hard because of the way I managed my mind and I focused on what I knew how to do. And I want to just suggest that if you all are learning how to stop over drinking and you're pushing yourselves and you're challenging yourselves and you're, you know, trying to drink less in situations when you normally wouldn't be drinking less. Like maybe it's at a party or a social event or out to dinner or just, you know, it was a stressful Tuesday afternoon. Okay. And you're trying to drink less or not at all. I would suggest that you focus on what you do know how to do. Okay. So maybe you haven't quite learned how to not drink as much as you normally do, right? Maybe that's something that you're still navigating and still learning. But there's so many things that you actually do know how to do, right? You know how to breathe. You know how to drink water. You know how to talk. You know how to write. You know how to ask questions. So depending on what kind of situation you're in, maybe you're out for dinner and you're worried about having urges, or you're worried about saying no to the server when they come around to ask you what you're gonna drink, right? And you just wanna order water, or a mocktail or something non-alcoholic, okay? And so in that situation, you wanna just tell yourself, okay, what do I know how to do right now? I know how to order food off of a menu. I know how to greet my guests. I know how to engage in conversation. I know how to drink water. I know how to eat. I know what foods I like, right? Like go down the list of everything that you know how to do. Okay. And that will fill your brain up with like, yeah, I got this. I know how to do so much. And you won't have time to be like, oh, I don't know what I'm going to do when the server comes around and like all of that chatter. So focus on what you know how to do. Okay. And then if it comes up like, oh, I'm having urges or you're feeling uncomfortable or something, you can say, oh, I'm having a sensation in my body that feels like my heart is racing, my mouth might be watering, my jaw might be clenched. Notice the sensation in your body when you are sitting there and you really want to drink and you have decided not to. Or if you've had one drink and you really want more, it's the same thing that applies, right? So you want to just notice what you are feeling. I am having sensations in my body. I'm feeling heart rate increase. I'm feeling my shoulders are almost up to my ears, right? Just notice those things and don't add extra language around it that feels extra hard, right? So like what that sound would sound like is like, this sucks. I really want to drink. This is hard. I don't know how to do this. Will this be like this forever? Why do I have to do it like this? Why can't I just drink like everybody else? That's that extra language that you don't need to have in your mind right now. So replace that language with, I know how to do what I just told you. I know how to drink water. I know how to order the menu. I know how to say hello to my friends or whoever I'm sitting here with. I know how to eat. I know how to sit. I know how to breathe. And I'm having some tightness in my jaw and I notice that my mouth might be watering. And then just breathe. I know how to breathe. And you just sort of repeat that to help you get through some of those times when it might feel uncomfortable. So I definitely use that today on my run. And anytime we're going through something that might be uncomfortable or in any situation, right? Like maybe there's a conflict at work or something with your family going on, right? So like the language that you have in your head about whatever situation that you find yourself in creates your experience with it. So my suggestion in this podcast is to focus on the things that you know how to do and put less focus on the things that you're not quite sure how to navigate or not do. Does that make sense? So when you fill your brain with all the things that you know how to do, you're intentionally thinking about those things, there's less room for all of the extra excess language that doesn't add anything to your experience, right? Like saying this is hard, this sucks, why can't I have a drink, makes your experience worse. When you think, oh, I know how to drink water, that's easy. I know how to order food, that's easy. I know how to put food in my mouth, that's easy. And I'm noticing some vibrations in my body. I'm having sensations in my body and maybe in my head that make me normally want to drink. And that's it. And then you take a couple deep breaths and you move through that. So it really is helpful when you do that. The language in your head and what you think creates your experience. And if you want to have a good experience, it's awesome to think about ways you can think about that, about your experience or what you're about to head into in a way that feels good and true, right? Like a lot of the things that I teach are about mindset, right? Changing your thoughts, creating new feelings, processing your feelings. But that's not like about mantras, right? It's more about believing thoughts that you or thinking thoughts that you can believe that are actually true. So when you fill your brain with, I know how to drink water, I know how to order food, they're not lies, right? They're facts that you can believe in that moment that you can hold on to instead of, I don't know how to not drink after one drink. I don't know how to say no to the server when they come around and ask what people want to drink. Right? If you focus on what you do know how to do, there's less room for the worry of the things that you don't know how to do. And just remind yourself that you're learning how to do those things. And it will become easier when you practice over time. All right, my friends, that's what I got for you today. Short and sweet. Focus the things on you know how to do. When you think about upcoming situations or times when you're wanting to reduce how much you're drinking, just remind yourself of all the things that you actually know how to do. And you know how to do them well. Practice thinking those in the time. Allow yourself to notice those vibrations in your body and breathe. And you got this. And keep practicing. Talk to you soon. Don't forget to get on the Q&A calls. We've got those for the new program. And click through and get your applications in to join Stop Over Drinking and Start Living 2.0. Talk to you next week. Bye.